So good morning, children. So today we are going to discuss the topic that already we have discussed, electronic dot structure of covalent molecules. First of all, what did we have seen? What is covalent bond? Covalent bond is nothing but sharing of electrons lead to the formation of covalent bond. So how many electrons can an atom contribute for sharing? How many electrons? So that is what we call it as valency. So valency is the very important factor here. So valency shows that how many electrons it requires, or how many electrons it can give, or how many electrons it can give for sharing. That number we will call it as valency. So if we know the valency, then automatically we can try and we can bring the electrons from other elements for sharing or from the same other element. Let us see the first example. That what we are going to see is simplest one, hydrogen. So while following follow the steps, first of all, which element we have chosen in the compound, what elements are there? Here we have chosen element hydrogen. Now I am writing the electronic configuration of hydrogen. Atomic number of hydrogen is 1. Electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1. So atomic number is very important. We need to by heart the atomic numbers of almost all elements. Approximately 30 elements is good, and some other elements electronic configuration also, atomic number also we need to by heart. And we got the electronic configuration. So we know that what are valence electrons? The electrons which are present in the last orbit are called valence electrons. Here the first orbit is the last orbit. How many electrons are there in first orbit? 1. Therefore, number of valence electrons are 1. Number of valence electrons are 1. Now, to attain the helium electronic configuration, helium atomic number is 2. It means it consists of 2 electrons. Hydrogen requires 1 more electron to get nearest helium electronic configuration. So what it does, it gives that electron which it is having for sharing, and it takes another electron from some another hydrogen. So it gives 1 electron, it takes another electron, but these 2 electrons will get shared by both the atoms, both the hydrogen atoms. So how many electrons it can give for sharing? What is its valency? That it says to us, valency is 1. So hydrogen gives 1 electron for the valency. Now we will draw the Lewis dot structure. You can see that hydrogen electron, this electron is shared by the both the hydrogens. This electron shared by both the hydrogens. That shared part I am showing at the middle. So these 2 electrons belongs to both the hydrogens. So this is the Lewis dot structure of hydrogen molecule. Now we are going to see another example, and remember we have to follow the same steps to answer the electron dot structure. Element or elements which are present in the compound, and write the electronic configuration of those elements or element, and find out the number of valence electrons in each, and find out the valency for each, and then try for the electron dot structure. So remember that step. Next we are going to see oxygen. Oxygen. So in this oxygen, which element is present? Oxygen itself is element. Oxygen atomic number is 8, and its electronic configuration is 2,6. How many valence electrons does oxygen consist of? What are valence electrons? The electrons which are present in the outermost orbit are called valence electrons. Here the first orbit, second orbit. Outermost orbit is the second orbit. The outermost orbit, second orbit, consists of 6 electrons, therefore valence electrons are 6. Why it is so important means when we draw the Lewis dot structure, so we have to put how many valence electrons are there, that many dots or intus. As oxygen is having 6 valence electrons, we need to put 6 dots or 6 intus. Now, how many electrons it can give for its sharing? We will get it from the valency. What does the valency will say? How many electrons it can give, it can take, or it can give for sharing. So here, the nearest electronic configuration for oxygen is neon. Neon atomic number is 10. So it requires more 2 electrons, then only it will become stable. So how many electrons it requires? 2. That required, we will call it as valency. So valency of oxygen is 2. It means it requires 2 electrons. Therefore, it gives 2 electrons for sharing. But oxygen is having 6 valence electrons, no? Among 6, it gives 2 electrons for sharing. Remaining 4 will be with oxygen only. That is what you can see in the Lewis dot structure. 4 dots, that will be with the oxygen only. And it gives 2 electrons for sharing. So the 6 electrons are of this oxygen, this 6 electrons are of this oxygen. These 2 electrons are sharing with these 2. So I am making a circle. So see that the shared pair will come in between the intersected rays here. Now if you see, in any circle, totally 8 electrons are there. So 8 electrons are there. So this 8 electrons indicating that it achieved the electronic configuration of neon. Now the oxygen attained to the stability. So this is the Lewis dot structure of oxygen. So now see Nanda, what is the steps we are following step by step? We are writing the element, and after that we are writing the electronic configuration. To write the electronic configuration, we must remember the atomic number. And from that we are finding the valence electrons. And basing on the valence electrons, we have to draw the Lewis dot structure. How many valence electrons are there, that many dots or intus we need to put. And next we need to find out the valency. Valency means how many electrons it can give or it requires or it can give for sharing. As nearest electronic configuration of oxygen, inert electronic configuration is neon. Neon atomic number is 10. Oxygen atomic number is 8. So it shows that it requires 2 electrons to have the 8 valence electrons in its outermost orbit. So it requires 2 electrons, that's why it calls the valency as 2. So how much valence is there, that many electrons only gives per sharing. So as 2 valence electrons, valency is 2, it gives 2 electrons for sharing. Okay, now you understand now? Okay, let us see another example. Nitrogen. So even the board is not clear, you can understand step by step, you write in the notes and follow the steps. First of all, what did I say? Nitrogen. Black marker this. So nitrogen. Nitrogen atomic number is 7. Now what is the electronic configuration of nitrogen? After 2,5. It means in first orbit 2 electrons are there. In second orbit 5 electrons are there. So second orbit is the last orbit. The last orbit consists of how many electrons? 5 electrons. Therefore, number of valence electrons are how many? Valence electrons. Valence electrons are 5. Why it is so important? We have to put that many dots or intus around the nitrogen. Nitrogen having 5 valence electrons, therefore we need to put 5 dots or intus. Now, we will find the valency. Valency. What does the valency shows there? Valency is nothing but how many electrons it can give, it can take, or it can share. Now, let me see that how many electrons it requires first of all. Atomic number of nitrogen is 7, it is having 5 valence electrons. How many more electrons it requires to achieve the nearest inert gas? 3 more electrons. So it requires 3 more electrons. That number is the valency of nitrogen. So valency of nitrogen is 3. Valency of nitrogen is 3. Therefore, it gives 3 electrons for sharing. So now let me draw the Lewis dot structure. So first of all, at the center, the electrons which are sharing, you draw that first. So as nitrogen is sharing 3 electrons, this is the shared nitrogen 3 electrons, but we have to keep the other 2 also which are there with the nitrogen. Actually these 5 belongs to this nitrogen, these 5 belongs to this nitrogen. But 3 electrons are getting shared now. So these electrons belongs to, shared electrons belongs to this nitrogen. These shared electrons belongs to this hydrogen also. Now you can see in the circle, totally 8 electrons will be there. As 3 electrons are shared, now that nitrogen attained the stability. So far we have seen 3 examples, H2. How many electrons each hydrogen contributed? 1 electron. That's why we say hydrogen having the single bond. And also we have seen O2. Each oxygen contributed 2 electrons for sharing. So we have to put 2 dashes indicating that double bond. And now we have seen N2. Nitrogen contributed 3 electrons for sharing. As 3 electrons are sharing, we say that the sharing between them, 3 electrons, that's why it is called as triple bond. So like this, we can write the electron dot structure by using the electronic configuration, valence electrons, valency. But we have to follow the systematic steps, and if you write in sentence frame, if you frame your sentences, your answer will be absolutely correct. Now, we are going to see the methane, CH4. We are going to see the methane, CH4. Now, what are the elements are present in this? Carbon. Carbon electronic configuration is 2-4. Hydrogen. Hydrogen electronic configuration is 1. How many valence electrons are there for carbon? Valence means the electrons which are present in the outermost orbit, 4. How many valence electrons are there for hydrogen? 1. Now, next step is valency of carbon. As it requires 4 electrons to get 8 electrons on the outermost orbit, the valency of the carbon is 4. And valency of hydrogen is 1. What does the carbon indicate? The number of valence electrons which are there in the outermost orbit, that valence, that Lewis dot structure. But we are taking the hydrogen, and it requires 4 electrons. So it takes 4 electrons from 4 hydrogens. We can see that each hydrogen is sharing its electron with carbon. Each hydrogen is sharing the electron with carbon. Make a circle. All these 8 electrons, shared electrons belongs to the carbon. But at the same time, this shared pair belongs to this hydrogen. 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 Okay, got it now? So now, CH4, this is called electron dot structure of CH4. So whatever may be the molecule they give, So you have to follow these steps to draw the electron dot structure. Thank you all of you.